to the moon side, Soulfly! Freedom! Hello. How everybody doing, all right? Make some noise for Soulfly, let me hear you. Everybody all right? I got Dana's little brother here, he's gonna sing Bleed with us. Are you ready to bleed? Let's go.
Thank you. Drive on! Drive! Never underestimate our power. Starting to leash, silence beast. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Roskilde in Denmark, everybody. You made a very special day for us in the Soulfly tribe. We'd like to end the show dedicating this shit to Hoodie and the Blowfish. Fuck Hoodie and the Blowfish! No!
Ding wat u ziet, dat is een beringbouw. Max Cavalera.
Hoi!
Yo, Holland. Welcome. Thank you very much for coming and showing up. Your respect and support. It means a lot for me to see all these people with Sepultura and Nailbomb shirts. Also the people in the back and everybody. So we're gonna try to do the best out of this, okay? I never did this before, so be patient. I'm gonna say a little bit about, you know, where I come from and, you know, why I'm here tonight. I grew up in Brazil, was born in Brazil in 1969, and all the way to here is like in Brazil, they always say, if you want to make it, since, you know, since I was a kid hearing from the people, you can be a football player and be big, and you can be a big drug dealer, you know, and you'll be big and make a lot of money. And I end up making with music. And in my country, they call me a bum. So, you know, it's the irony of life. So I'm going to give a brief history. I'm not going to bother bug you out with too many stuff, you know, just little brief what been true with me with my 14-year career with Sepultura. Everything started after I saw Queen in São Paulo, the soccer stadium, Murumbi. I was 10 years old, and after I saw Queen, I came back home and I told my mother, that's the job I want to do. You know, I don't want anything else, that's it. Go on the stage and scream and loud guitars. It's my career, you know. Forget about everything else. That's the real meaning. The other interesting part of it was my father, which was Italian. And he passed away in 79. But I went to peek at his record collection to see, you know, what he listened to. Mostly was Italian boring opera. And I found Led Zeppelin Volume 4 and Black Sabbath Volume 1 in his record collection. And somehow my dad was already sneaking behind the family listening to heavy music. So that's really, I think, you know, where it really came from, why I started, you know, play heavy metal, you know, in Brazil, the country of carnival and samba. Why do I play this extreme music, you know? That explains a little bit of that. Move on to a little bit later, when I did my first contract with Cogumelo Records from Brazil, and it was an underground independent label, and the only reason they signed Sepultura because we were so terrible. You know, we couldn't play, and we had a fight after the show with some people, religious people, group people, and they told me, I think you're really bad, you're a terrible band, but you had great, you know, attitude, and you had a fight, and your shows are total chaos, I'm gonna sign you. So, at that time, you have to learn how to play our instruments. That was the first thing we thought, you know. Might be a good idea to learn how to play, you know. So we move on to learning how to play our instrument. We still don't know that. We'll get that somewhere. And start doing the first Brazilian tours, 48 hours in a bus with people, chicken, pigs, dogs, other things that I'm not gonna mention. And those are the real hardcore first Sepultura tours, like really hardcore. And from that on, I took the step finally, we were growing kind of bored of just that. And I decided I gotta find a way to make my music go outside Brazil, because I felt in my heart it should go beyond Brazil. And I got a free ticket from a friend in extinct Pan Am Airlines. And the way to do that, that's a funny story. The only way for me to get this ticket, I had to dress with a tie and really nice, you know, like executive, put Vaseline in my hair, and look like a normal person and act like one too. So I did that, you know, it was the only way to go to America. Didn't have no money. It was only 2 days. I got in the airport and the people that picked me up, they were all hard rock fans, Monty Connor from Roadrunner. And they look at me and they totally start laughing, you know. I have a tie and it's like, this is Max Cavalera. And he took me around then with Borivoj around New York. I put, at that time, Schizophrenia was Sepultura's record. I left in 10 record labels, and 2 days after flew back to Brazil. And I have no idea, like, really no hope that nothing's gonna happen. I came back and told them, you know, the albums are there, maybe something happened. And 2 months after that, we got a phone call from Roadrunner, and they wanted to sign the band. And all I can remember is everybody was jumping, like, this high, you know, and we couldn't believe it. It was one of those moments in life that you go on forever. I'm always going to remember that. And really, you know, Roadrunner gave us the first break outside Brazil. We start doing our tours. Some of you people might remember the Beneath the Remains tour. I don't know, some of the hardcore fans. And one cool thing about that tour, we were touring with Sodom from Germany, and they didn't really like us too much. And we're starting to get better every day because we're really hungry to play. And they start cutting our sound and cutting our lights and just fucking with us every night. So I decided to fuck back with them. And the way I did that is I decided to stop taking shower and only wear the same clothes all the way to the end of the tour. That lasted for 3 weeks. They wanted to kill me in the end of the tour, you know. They hate me. But that was my way to protest against what they were doing to us. When I came back home for the first time, somehow the Brazilian media heard about that story, and I got called on the biggest Brazilian television to talk about my three-week non-shower experience. And that was the first time my mother got to see me on Brazilian television. It was embarrassing. Anyway, we move on from that to the first, you know, shows. And when I met Gloria in New York in 1990, we opened up for King Diamond. And it was a great show. It was a sold out, 3,000 people. And first time we met Gloria, she told right away to the whole band, I want this band. I want to work with you because there's something about Sepultura that, I don't know, I can't explain, but I really want. And she worked with us for 1 year without contract and without getting pay. And she, from that moment on, I knew we were safe and we had a person that was looking after our art for the first time. Because before that, everybody just really kind of fucked with us and stole and didn't care, you know. At that moment, we knew we had somebody, and she stayed all the way until now, you know, until my split with Sepultura. So I would like, from my heart, for people to give like a respect applaud to Gloria and to everything, the work that she did to Sepultura for all this time. You know, I would really appreciate that. Thanks a lot. Then we did Rock in Rio and things like that. We ended up doing Chaos AD after our rise at Chaos AD, and it was the first time we experimented with percussion. We found our own roots somewhere. We realized we had that and should become part of our music. So we bring in the percussion. Percussion was finally part of Sepultura. We found ourselves. And Chaos AD ended up being recorded at Rockfield, where Queen recorded Night of the Opera and Black Sabbath and Led Zeppelin, a lot of classic bands. And I think, you know, from that moment on, we've really found a style, original. Everybody stopped calling Sepultura like similar to Slayer or similar to Metallica. Sepultura was finally Sepultura, his own band. And we did the first Donington and also the first Dynamo. Some of you people remember. And that was, all I can say, one of the best shows I ever had. And it was the first time we really saw the acceptance of a major crowd in a festival. We never dreamed that we could play in front of so many people and have such a strong impact. And the Dynamo, you know, was really the first show, we felt like that. We still talk about it today. Everybody that was there saw a very special moment that I'm gonna remember forever, you know, a really, really special festival. And all I can say, I hope I can be at Dynamo again sometime. Thank you. I don't want to bother you, so I'm trying to go kind of fast, you know. We did the Roots album then. I'm going to move on to Roots. Very experienced and very exciting album for all of us, and mainly for me, because I dream about this album 1 year before it was released. And I dream about going back to my country and working with the Indians and meeting the very first people of Brazil that was there before all of us. And that was really the meaning behind, strong meaning behind Roots. And to do that and work with the Indians and stay there for 3 days in the tribe, it's just, there's no way to even explain that experience. It's something that I think is one in a lifetime that happened. And I thank God a lot for giving me that chance and opportunity to be part of something like that. And I think also it was good because it brought out in a lot of the youth the meaning about preserving the culture, which is very forgotten today by, you know, by the media, by MTV. Really, it became like fast food music. It was very refreshing for me to have an album that was talking about Indians in a world that didn't care about that shit anymore. You know, as I really felt we did something very different and very with a meaning. Mainly being in a rock group, metal group, that everybody expects you to be completely brain dead, you know, and expect you just to be, you know, not at all a person that will care about Indian or political statements. And I think that made a difference for Sepultura and for my career. Also, the fact that we work with Carlinhos Brown and John from Korn and Mike Patton from Faith No More also brought up a new flavor to the record. And right now, all I can say, I'm just really proud of that record. Even Sepultura no longer exists. Roots always going to exist for what it was. And I got to thank Europe, all over Europe, you know, Holland, France, Germany, everywhere, England, for the acceptance. The album went gold almost every country here. And that, for me, was a real, the real payoff of my work. To see all those years and all that I put into Roots was paying me back in respect, the people that come to me on the street and talk about how much they really dig what we did, that's different than most of people. And of course I gotta talk a little bit of the split, which really, if I don't know if people know or not, but it really started last year, unfortunately, with the Donington tragedy, that I lost my stepson, Gloria lost her son, Dana. And he was just, Dana was the biggest influence in, like literally probably of all people I knew in music. He was the main influence in my career because he was always giving me new ideas and new bands. He introduced me to this new generation of bands like Korn and Deftones, Wheelhaven, the newer blood of the hard music. And to lose him was just too much of a loss. For me, that after his death, everything really changed and went upside down, and Sepultura changed their ideals. And all I can say is that my beliefs continue the same with what I'm doing, and that's why I'm not with Sepultura, unfortunately, because I didn't want Sepultura to turn into another, just another mainstream group doing everything they are told to. I want us to continue to do what we want to. And that's the way the fans want it, I really believe. And that's why, you know, really, in the end of the day, I could not stay no longer in Sepultura because the integrity was gone, was really fucked up. And for me, it was really hard to continue in Sepultura and keep lying to myself when that bullshit was going on. So I got through that. It was real hard. I wanted to quit music at one point. But a lot of the fans and a lot of the real special people in the whole world made me nonstop, made me somehow in a spiritual way tell me, continue because you have a lot to say to a lot of people. And I just took a big breath and say, I'm going all the way now. I'm forming a new group. I'm going to find people that have the same passion that I have. It's a fire that burns inside. And that fire is still burning more than ever. And I say, I'm going to continue. Right now, I believe I found these people. And I hope next year to be active again, just as I was with Sepultura. And all I can say about my music, if somebody asks me how it's going to be, I say it's going to be everything from the heart. And that's the best way I can describe. You know, it's more important that it's from the heart than if it's reggae, metal, or samba, or whatever the fuck. It's from the heart, and that's how I describe. And thank you so much again. You know, this is not normal for me. So I'm going to talk a bit about the future. We're moving on. October, I'm going to enter the studio. I'm going to do the album with Ross Robinson that did Roots. Andy Wallace is going to mix. Some of the songs we're gonna work with Mario Caldato. He's the producer of the Beastie Boys. So something wild is gonna come out of that shit. Which is like always trying to come up with something wicked and trippy in the end of the day. And of course a lot of the aggressive and a lot of the songs with attitude, because this album is a pain album. It's an album built in pain. It was built in a different situation. I never expect to write this record. So I think when people read the lyrics and hear the music, it's going to be better than any interview or any spoken word I can ever do in a million years. So I leave it like that. I leave it to the people to hear the album when it's out and make their own judgment, you know. And just thanks everybody that came here tonight and heard for what I had to say. I would like to say this. Anybody have questions to ask me at all? I know you guys kind of shy. I tell you what, fuck the questions. I'm just going to do a jam. That's the other thing I came here to. Let the music speak. This jam, I just met two friends of mine. Thank you. It's Larry and Astro. And they were supposed to perform, but it got canceled, but they're going to perform with me. So feel free to fuck shit up, you know, it's another jam. Ready? Make some noise, man. Come on. More, more, more. Senhor das demandas, onde zumbi chega, é zumbi quem manda. Participation, come on, everybody stand up, let's see this shit. Stand up, come on, man. shy. Larry and Astro, thank you so much, Holland. You know, it's been fun, man. You know, it's different, but it was cool. I thank all the people that came and showed their respect and support again. We'll see you on the festivals next year, okay? All right, peace.